Hi YouTube, and welcome to Hamach YouTube channel. Today I have Adam here. We're gonna open up the Antminer S9 Bitcoin machine. I'm very, very excited because this is the most powerful Bitcoin machine ever been created.
Right now.
Right now, at the moment. They always make a new one much faster than the old one. But this one right now is the strongest one. This one has 12.0 terahashes per second, which is 12 trillion transactions per second.
How much money does that actually make?
It makes about 0.25 bitcoins, a quarter bitcoins per month.
Like 250 bucks?
Yeah, 260 bucks in current.
Per month?
Per month.
Okay, how much does that cost?
It costs about 1,500, 1,600 bucks.
Okay, so you make your money back in 4 months.
You basically, but you have to consider electricity cost. You also need a power supply, which I have also. I have a 1,600 watt power supply EVGA to run this beast. You have to get at least 1,600 watt power supply to run the Antminer S9, because it takes about 1,300 watts. But you want to be a little bit above that, just to be in case with the power supply.
So you buy. You buy this machine. And then if I wanted to mine Bitcoins, right, and make that kind of money.
Right.
I buy this machine, I buy the power supply.
Right.
How much is the power supply?
The power supply is about $400. You might be able to get it used for a little less. Okay. But at least I know that the power supply is an investment for a long time, because the power supply keep working for years.
Right, it stays.
Right, and okay. Bitcoin machines do have to be replaced every now and then when difficulty goes up and up and up.
Difficulty?
The Bitcoin difficulty.
So, in mining, okay.
Right,
okay.
So when you mine Bitcoins, right now you can get 12 and a half Bitcoins per 10 minutes, and this machine obviously cannot do it alone. You have to join a pool of people who also have different machines, and together, with your power hashing together, you can get the 12 and a half bitcoins and everybody splits it.
Okay, so everyone that is mining Bitcoin is getting a piece of the 12 and a half bitcoins that's released every 10 minutes.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly. You can try to mine on your own. It's called solo mining. That means you're not in any group, you're just trying to get it on your own. But because the difficulty of Bitcoin is so high, it might take you a very, very long time to hit one time to win that, you know, to win that Bitcoin.
So if I had like 10 of these machines, I'd basically be like one of the supreme guys in that pool mining most of the mining.
Exactly. Okay. You can make your own pool. So the cool part is you can make your own pool with as many machines as you have, and all of them together solo mine, and then they try to hit that 12 and a half Bitcoins. So you can actually try to do that, and you'll have a lot more chances to hit that 12 and a half. And that's what is basically a pool is. That's what is a pool and solo mining. But if you have enough machines, you can start your own pool.
Let's open it up.
Okay, let's open the box. So this is just arrived from China. That's where they're coming from.
You got it from China?
I got it from China.
So you bought it from, it came from China.
It came from China, I bought it. I paid in Bitcoins and got it here. China.
You bought it in Bitcoins?
Yeah, actually you buy those things in Bitcoins. You buy the machines in Bitcoins. It's pretty cool. Yeah, it's pretty awesome. It comes here, it's from bitmain.com. You can check it out. It comes with a little paper here, show you the warranty. You get 3 month warranty, I think. If you burn it, you don't have warranty. So be careful burning it. Now this one runs so hot, I will show you guys later. So let's open up. I'm gonna do this.
So it could burn, and then...
Absolutely, it can burn, yeah.
Why don't you just put it in a cool storage, right? You put it somewhere kind of cold, and then it won't burn?
Right. That's why a lot of people like to mine in cold places, like Canada or China.
Can you put it in, like, in a giant freezer? Would that help?
Yeah, you can probably maybe overclock it.
What if I wanted to use it as a heater for my house? Can I do that?
I actually did it in our last video, Antminer R4. Check it out. It's actually a miner for the home.
So you didn't turn on the heater. You just turned on your Bitcoin miner and your house was hot.
Yeah, exactly. So I will show you guys some features of this machine. So this is where the power goes. This is where you plug in all the power connections. This is the powering the main board, which connects to the Ethernet and control the boards. You have an in and out fan here. I believe this is the intake, and that's coming out of here. And then we're gonna have to plug in the power supply to the each board. So let's do it right now. I'm going to put this right here.
You said internet?
Oh, right. We also have an internet connection in the front. You have to have an internet connection right here with a regular internet.
Why?
Because that's how it connects to the Bitcoin network and mine and gets you the reward. If it's running offline, it doesn't do
anything.
Okay,
so you're connected to the... This needs to be connected to the internet to mine Bitcoins so that when you mine them, you get it into your Bitcoin wallet. So it needs to be connected to the internet. Okay, cool.
Exactly.
So, okay, so power supply and internet. You need
power supply, internet, and the machine.
Okay.
And a place to put it.
Right.
And it cannot be hot. Too hot.
So definitely not your bedroom where you'll sweat.
Yeah, this one. And also very, very loud. So this thing is very loud. This is a commercial unit, I would say, for commercial units where you have net, you know, like server room of some sort. It's very, very loud and powerful and hot. There are one for the home. They're a little more quiet, a little less powerful, but you can actually mine them at home.
It doesn't look that big. You can't really commercial?
We'll see. Now I'm going to bring in the power supply and we're going to plug it in. So, like last video, Adam here is gonna help me connect it in so you can have the experience of plugging it in. You guys are gonna do the same when you're gonna have your own machine. Every Bitcoin machine is gonna need power, especially the new ones, because they have their own power supply that you have to provide. So, here is all the cables.
Does it matter where each one goes or no?
It doesn't really matter, but as you can see, some of them are split. I use the split ones for the board, for the each of the boards here. Of the hashing boards, and I use the single one to power up the main motherboard of the Bitcoin machine. So I'm gonna start plugging in right now like this. And then plug each one.
So it doesn't matter which ones go
to doesn't really matter. As long as your power supply can support this kind of power. As you can see, this is a EVGA 1600 watt, which is good enough for this machine.
So this machine, this Antminer 9,
S9
needs at least 1300 watts.
At least 1300 watts, but I always
go over to be safe.
Go okay. Over, yeah. You don't want to stress out the power supply. And also, if you get exactly the same amount, if you get a overpowered power supply, sometimes the efficiency goes higher, and your electricity cost goes a little bit lower.
You mean the better the power supply, the more efficient the machine runs?
Yeah, the more efficient the power supply runs. If you keep pushing the limits of the power supply,
okay.
The efficiency of the power supply goes a little
down. Because it gets burnt.
It gets hot, okay. And it gets less efficient. So,
makes sense.
Let's plug in here. And this one goes here. So basically, there are 9 power cables, VGA connections to the machine, and then one to the motherboard, so total 10. 10 different VGA, it's like video card power cables.
You have to connect all of them?
You have to connect all of them. Do not run some of them. This machine will burn. It's very, very sensitive. Okay, so we plugged everything in, and we're gonna go ahead and now power it up.
All right, guys, we're back. So in this part, we're basically connecting this power supply that we talked about directly to the power outlet. While you do this, keep the power supply off. There's a switch. So keep that switch off while connecting it to the power. And then now that we have this machine hooked up to the power supply, we need to connect it to the internet so that when you do mine Bitcoins, you want it to go to your account, right? So rather than running an Ethernet cable like around the house from upstairs to here, we're just gonna use this adapter. It's called power over internet.
Ethernet over power.
Internet over power. It just uses the copper in your house for power. It uses it as internet.
Exactly. There's another one of those next to my router.
Yeah, that's connected.
It creates a network over my
so basically house. You can use internet all around your house. It's a pretty cool device. But for this, it's convenient, right? So now this machine is connected directly to the internet. As soon as we turn this power supply on, it's gonna make a lot of noise just to show you how much noise it makes so you can figure out where you want to put this machine if you do get it.
It's very, very loud, guys. Probably not for a house use. Maybe in the garage. That's why there is the Antminer R4, a little more quiet, but it is less powerful. So this is more powerful and more loud as well, and takes more electricity. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn it on. Be ready, guys. Scariest part.
It's not that bad.
Oh, okay, wait, yeah. It's gonna take a couple of minutes. Usually a Bitcoin miner doesn't start mining until about maybe 20 minutes past.
So the hot air is gonna blow from here soon?
Yeah, the hot air is blowing. It's already started to blow. Oh, here you go. Okay.
It's gonna be like this all the time?
That's how it is all the time. All the time.
Okay.
So imagine it's in your bedroom or...
Turn it off.
Okay. Okay, right. Let's turn it off now.
Okay,
so I'm gonna turn it off now.
Okay, so yeah, that's pretty loud. You might not want to put that in your bedroom, probably in your garage. So 1600 watts. That's, what is that, like 40 cents an hour?
So basically it takes about, I would say, yeah, about 13 to 14, maybe even 20 cents per hour running this machine.
Well, at our
rate. Our rate is about 15, 16 cents per hour.
Yeah, we're
Los
Angeles, so it's gonna cost us how much cents per hour?
17 to 20 cents per kilowatt.
Okay, so you're gonna account for the cost of electricity when you and plus the cost of this machine, plus the cost of the power supply, and then you take those are like, this is a fixed cost, the power supply is a fixed cost, and then I guess the electricity is a variable cost.
And also the difficulty of the network keep going up because more people are mining. So every time there's another machine running, the difficulty goes a little higher. So then over time, it depends on how many people buy the machines, how many people are mining.
So the more people that are mining, it's just harder to get that, make that Bitcoin money value thing.
Exactly, exactly. Okay. So to know how to set up the Bitcoin machine with the network so the Bitcoins that it earns goes to your account, you can follow the video below for my Antminer R4 review. In the end of the video, I actually went online, find what the port and the Bitcoin, the IP address of the machine is, went in and changed the settings. So you can see that on the video below.
So, okay, so it's connected to the internet now, and then you're talking about going on your computer and then scanning which port this is.
Exactly, this is gonna open a new IP address. So it's 192.168.1.something. And it's gonna change every time you plug in a new machine, or if you have several machines, each one has its own IP address. You have to log into those IP address and change the settings so it will mine under your name and not someone else. By default, Bitmain website have their own information in there.
What are they called?
Bitmain.
Bitmain?
Bitmain. That's the company who makes them. You can go online, check it out. That's where you can buy them as well.
Okay, so this is a whole other side. I mean, this is actually the computer side to it. You just go on a computer, log in online, connect this port to your Bitcoin wallet.
Right.
So the money goes to your account. Okay, cool.
Exactly.
That makes sense.
Yeah, exactly. So thank you so much for viewing this video. I want to thank People channel to win the giveaway. Good job.
He won?
Yeah, he won randomly. I do giveaways on the channel to Bitcoin giveaways to increase awareness. And also, I always post videos about Bitcoins and how they work.
That guy just won some Bitcoin.
He won some Bitcoin just by subscribing. So you guys can do the same and subscribe to the channel. Comment what do you think about the Antminer S9. Maybe you can comment about the next machine that's going to come up, more powerful maybe. And anything else you want to know, or if you have any questions, you can also post about that. Bye.
Thanks.
Bye, guys.